So the last time we tried to film chlorine experiments, we found that the chlorine cylinder itself had a slight problem. It was seized here, but the Stig has acquired another cylinder of chlorine. So you know what this means. It means that we feel duty bound to increase the intensity of our chlorine video and show you some chemistry with chlorine.
Chlorine is an element that many people have heard of. It's a greenish yellow gas, and which consists of the gas consists of two chlorine atoms bonded together, so it's Cl2. And it's much heavier than air.
Incredibly reactive, incredibly poisonous, not a very nice compound at all. Okay, so Neil is about to open the cylinder of chlorine to allow some chlorine gas to leak through the pipe into the flask in the fume hood. Chlorine sits in the right hand side of the periodic table, in the halogens in group, well, some people say 7, some people say 17. Really what that says is that chlorine wants another electron to get that noble gas configuration, and it will move heaven and earth to get that electron.
So during the First World War, it was used as a chemical weapon. The gas could spread across the battlefields, and when it came to the trenches, which were holes in the ground, it would fall into the trenches and fill them up.
You can see the yellow colour against the white background on the paper. So now we're starting to fill that flask with chlorine. It's quite dense, so it will stick to the bottom of the flask. It's not like a light gas, like hydrogen or helium. It won't come upwards. So now you can see the colour in that chlorine is really quite intense.
It wasn't a terribly good weapon because it could quite easily, if the wind changed direction, it could blow the gas back to the people who were letting it out.
So we'll just put a stopper in to contain the gas while we prepare the rest of the experiment.
Chlorine is quite corrosive. It reacts with water to make an acid, HCl, hydrochloric acid, which can attack people's lungs. The lungs generate fluid, they fill up with fluid, and quickly the person drowns in their own fluid. It also corrodes things very easily, so all the metal fittings on people's battle dress, the brass buttons, brass buckles, all went green as well. But it's not a terribly effective weapon, but when people weren't expecting any sort of chemical weapon, it must have been terrifying.
Okay, so we have a small amount of aluminium here, which we put on the end of a wire. We're going to heat the aluminium in that flame, and then we're going to put the hot aluminium into the flask of chlorine. Then hopefully we'll see the chlorine will react with the aluminium, and we'll get very rapid formation of aluminium trichloride, AlCl3.
The British Army created whole regiments of gas soldiers who were all trained chemists who were sent out to handle these cylinders of gas. And on the German side in the First World War, Fritz Haber, the inventor of the Haber process to make ammonia, became very keen on chemical weapons, and he was the chief proponent. His wife was really furious about this, and in fact shot herself with his revolver, killed herself the day before he was due to go back to the front. And it was said that this was because she objected to his work on chemical weapons. Though at the same time, there were rumours that he was having an affair with another woman, so there may have been other factors at play as well.
So, let's heat up our aluminium. Okay, so it's nice and warm all over. And then we'll drop it, we'll add it into the chlorine glass. Now instantly we're seeing aluminium trichloride coming out of the top and reacting with moisture in the air. So now you can see the reaction is getting very intense, and we're seeing a flame in the bottom. So So the aluminium is being consumed as it's reacting, oxidizing strongly in that chlorine-rich air.
Chlorine is found all over the world. The sea contains sodium chloride, and there are huge deposits of sodium chloride in salt lakes where lakes have dried out, such as in some parts of the States, where you United States, where you have salt lakes, where people can race cars and things across the flat surface, and in other parts of the world.
All of the aluminium has been consumed now by the chlorine. Very, very rapid reaction.
There are many areas, such as in the north of England, in the county of Cheshire, and also in Salzburg in Austria, where there are prehistoric deposits of salt from prehistoric salt lakes, which can now be mined really quite easily. And there's so salt and chlorine is a very common element. It's made from sodium chloride solution by electrolysis, by passing electric current. And it's a very energy intensive process. 1% of the UK's electricity was used at one time for making chlorine from sodium chloride. And the chlorine is used particularly for making the plastic PVC.
While we got chlorine here, we thought we'd do a couple of reactions. So we've got some chlorine in this flask, and you can see the nice yellow colour. And I thought what we'd try and do now is do a competition reaction again, or a reaction with iron. So now the iron, we're going to heat the iron. This is iron wool, which you might use for treating wood. And we're going to heat that till it's warm and put it in the chlorine. The chlorine will oxidize it to iron chloride.
Chlorine will react with all sorts of metals. You can make salt by burning the metal sodium in chlorine. And if you put in other metals like aluminium or iron, they will also react. Aluminium reacts to form aluminium trichloride, which is the salt of aluminium, and iron will similarly react to form iron chloride. And most metals, but not all of them, will react with chlorine. Lead will not, for example, but it is really quite a reactive gas.
So really rapid reaction there as the hot iron starts to react with the chlorine to form iron chloride. Very, very exothermic again. And I think, yes, this is very hot. We might have to move it off the paper.
So what happens in all of these reactions is that the chlorine removes an electron from the metal to make the chloride ion, Cl-. And the chloride ion is perfectly innocuous. You can drink, you can eat chlorine, chloride, whereas chlorine itself is very poisonous.
Well, it's warm. It's not too hot, Dutch. It's like picking up a mug of warm tea or a warm coffee. But you can see, again, the products of the chemical reaction are precipitated out across the flask. And now if I remove the wire again, I can see that all of the iron has been consumed instantly the moment that it got into that chlorine-rich flask. Very, very rapid reaction. Very, very reactive with chlorine.